Good morning. My name is Chad Evans. I'm one of the technical managers here at Saratech. And we've had a few people come in and ask about the Creo Translator and how it works with NX. So there's kind of two different ways within the Creo Translator, how I personally like to use it. You can use it as a single file within the software, or you could use it outside the software as a bulk translator if I wanted to translate multiple files. But the first thing I want to mention is it is a license-dependent software. So you can see here I have the NX Creo Translator. It is NX30603 that is added to my Soldto account. And then there's some prereqs I have to do. So I need to make sure that the Java is installed on my computer because of the fact that I am using, I like to use the bulk translator, but I'm going to scroll down and see that I've got that I do have Java. So here's the Java development kit. It is installed and pointing to which directory I have it installed at. And I also have the Java runtime. So those are two prereqs that are required. If you try to run the Creo translator and you get a Java error, that's why. Okay. So the first thing I would probably do is let's look at individual models. So if I have a little directory here called Creo. Rico is one of our engineers that was working on a project. And she had sent over a .prt.1 file, which was just a single file within you know, Creo. But say if I wanted to translate that single file, I could do this within my NX session. I could just start up. I currently have NX2206 installed because that's what she wanted the file converted to. So I can come over here and go File, Import, and if you notice here, it says imports Creo models into a work part. So I could say a new model, but I'm just going to use the translator that which is built inside of NX, and I'm going to select that individual part. Let's go back to my Creo directory right here, and here's a single file. So here is the dot part or the dot one. You can see here is the different options under the Creo that it is looking for. Okay, I'll select that file. I'll say okay to this. And then I can say apply or I can say okay. I'll just hit apply here. It's going to go out there and look. A little window pops up on my other screen that it's in process, that it's importing. And then when it's all said and done, it should disappear here in a few seconds. And then when I'm all said and done, I'll have a .prt. So now it has been completed. So now I come back to that single directory. There is my .prt file. So now I could go ahead and say open. Let's go back to that directory to my Creo. Here is the single part. I can open this up inside of NX. And when I open it up, you can see it's zoomed back a little bit. If I double click on the background, it literally fits to my screen. And then there's my individual part. So this was a part that I currently had brought in, you know, by itself singly. All right, so now I'll go ahead and close this down. I don't need that anymore. Let me go ahead and minimize this because now what I want to show you is I also have a bulk. So maybe I have multiple Creo files that I want to translate at any given time. Okay, because maybe I am the translator guy or I'm the engineer and I just received a bunch of files from my customer. They're all in Creo. So now I'm going to go to All Apps. I'm going to scroll down to my Siemens NX folder, which is right here. Let's use the 2206. And I'm going to scroll down. I see a translator right here, Translator Creo. So let's go ahead and select this. Java window pops up. See, you can see it meets the requirements. And then all of a sudden my Java GUI pops up. So the first thing I'll do is let's pick that folder. So that folder where I currently have all the geometry sitting at. And I'll go to my Saratech folder, go Creo right here. I've got the bulk. So I have a bunch of files here. Okay, I can select all those files at once. I'll say open. So you can see I've literally selected all those files and I'm going to translate them all the .prts. All right, this is where they're going to be based at. I could specify another location if I wanted to, but that's fine. We'll put them in the same directory. Down below, I've got a little execute here. So I'm going to go ahead and translate. So now you see in the background, it is literally translating each individual part right here. So you can see there's the first one. It also tells me it's using 2206.89 8,900 is my current patch level. So there, it's gone to the first one. It's on the second one. It looks like it's on the third one now. So you can see I'm starting to open these up. Or they're starting to create the .prt. See right here? It's converting the Creo, creating the .prt. So now I can look at that bolt file, and you can see now they're starting to appear. See, there's my 1, 2, 3 that I just saw on my screen. So if I wanted to, I could come in here and open up that 0119, go into my NX session. Let's go back a level. Let's go to the bulk. There's my 0119. There's my first part. See, as they're popping in because they're translating in the background. All right, there's my first part. Let's do the fit the screen. And there's my part. I'll zoom it back a little bit. Looks like it's some sort of bar there. All right, so not too bad. I can pan this over if I wanted to. So there's my two options. So I did it. I first showed you as a single, and then I also showed you as a bulk translator. So I showed you both ways. And I don't need all this gear stuff on my screen. There we go. That looks more normal. So I showed you both ways, the single translator with the Creo translator and also the bulk translator.
Thanks for checking out our channel. If you like what you saw, make sure to like and subscribe down below so you don't miss out on any new videos. Follow us on LinkedIn, Facebook, and Twitter for the latest engineering news and information. And to see all of our upcoming events, please visit our website at saratech.com/events.